an outside perspective that I think is the only thing that I can offer here, not knowing sufficiently the particular parameters of the problems in Milan, though of course what is remarkable is how similar these issues sound to the problems that face cities all around the world. In terms of the balance between creating new opportunities for an increasingly mobile world population, both at the very high end, which is to say the kind of global nomads, such as architect Fuxas and myself, whose carbon footprint is very, very bad, and who travel all around the world, and of course at the very low end, where the same economic forces that scour and remove every bit of value from the landscape as quickly as possible, thereby set adrift millions of people who must travel around the world in order to stay alive. And I think it's very important to realize, Mr. Fuxas spoke about immigrants, and we often tend to think of them as people who have foisted themselves upon us for some mysterious reason. And of course it is the same economic logic that allows us in the Western world to profit from manufacturing processes and low food prices globally, with food imported from third world countries and factories in China and India. It is those very same processes that produces the immigrants' dreams that then come back to haunt us in Italy, in the Netherlands, in the United States, everywhere. We do live in a global society. And in that global society, we are producing at a massive scale social injustice and environmental devastation. It is clear. It is a fact. It is true in Milan. It is true in Cincinnati, Ohio, where I live. It is true everywhere. What can we do about this? Well, I am neither an architect, nor a preservation person, nor a builder. So I only can try from a distant perspective and through the fantastic mechanism of the Venice Architecture Biennale, which is a mechanism for bringing people from all over the world together to think about these kind of issues, to try and propose not solutions, but perhaps some thoughts on how to approach these issues. So what I'm going to say will not offer specific solutions, maybe only some thoughts on how one might begin to approach these issues. And if you come to Venice in September, in October, November, and of course you must, starting on September 14th, then I hope you can see some experiments in this direction. So, what to do? I think first of all, what is important is to say what not to do and what is not possible. As we were walking in here today, there was the music playing. I don't know if any of you recognize it, Eddie Vedder's music for the movie Into the Wild, which is a movie about a young man who says, basta, this is all terrible, I am going to remove myself from society completely and I'm going to go into the wild. And he dies, literally, but of course also metaphorically. One cannot escape, which also means one cannot escape into the past. One cannot escape into rejecting modernity and rejecting our capitalist system completely. Some of us might want to do this, and perhaps someday we can find ways of, as Gramsci said, growing through it, but I think it is impossible to just remove it completely, unless anyone here has a few good atom bombs. It's impossible.